Hi folks, and welcome back once more to Let's Play Vintage Story. Let's play, ha! Let's stick around! Vintage Story. Apparently, put out my torch. I remember nothing. It's been like 2 weeks since I recorded the last episode. Really? Control right click to ignite. Control right click, you ain't igniting. Oh, it's because, it's in my offhand. A novel. There we go. Do that. Take this. So Jamal has told me that torches in this, if you just lob them, you can see they still shed light. Very cool. We needed a mod for that in Minecraft. All right. I just took something off the wall. Video games, why? All right. Let's dump some stuff here. Fat and things. Oh no, cattails, all right. Nuggets of casserole. Oh, that's right, we found some tin, hell yeah. That is our gateway to bronze, eventually. Is that a random little food pot just sitting there with some meat stewing it? It's got 39 days on it. How's the rest of this stuff? Some of it is spoiling. Wonderful. I don't know why. So like, all right, so this is spoiled. This is fresh for 1.9. There's really no points in putting it on the shelves at this point, I suppose. But yeah, I know we're gonna be needing another pick. I think I have ingots already made. So that'll be a thing that we'll be dealing with eventually. But first, got a bunch of bush meat, which I would love to be able to make something with, but we can't. .8 servings. How do I... Where's that one that's empty? Because we can cook with all this bush meat that we have come here. Right click to place on ground. Yes, but how? Ah, shit. Transfer liquid. Shift right click. Is that actually doing anything? I don't think it is. Oh, apparently I need a bucket. Go away! We can add things. So can I, like, place the bowl? Guides. Build walls of cellars from soil, brick, or stone. Up to 7x7. Yeah. Any fully enclosed space is considered a cellar. I don't know why this is not considered a cellar. Unless it's because there's like low fertility soil. I honestly do not know. Mildly irksome, though, I can tell you that. Does that do it? 1.31. No, it's still 1.3. I have no idea why it's not. Because, yeah, see, now the vegetable pair speed's like 0.99. What the fuck is going on with this game? It's being weird. So confused. We have so much digging to do. This is terrible. This is gonna be the next 45 minutes. I'm sorry. I don't even know. What time is it? It's going on nighttime, so now's the time to be doing this shit, though, I suppose. Instead of sleeping, we dig. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right. Only 5 tall. That is acceptable. All right, we're gonna need to go and fuss about with things. You just stay right over there, you fucking hell portal. All right. Do I have ingots? I do. Pass gene, you rogue. All right, we need coal. I don't actually know how much. 5. All right. I mean, that's control to add 1. There we go. And Jamal's told me you can like draw with coal or something. I don't know. I'm not gonna worry about it. Unimportant. What is important right now is not doing what I just fucking did. Good lord. Take this. Put it on there. All right, we have our hammer and everything. Actually, can I put a lit torch on this? That would have been funny. I mean, you can always just put it like this, but I don't like doing that because that will eventually go out. All right, so we have this tin ore somewhere in our inventory. Oh, some spoiled bushmeat. Looks delicious. Smelting temperature, 20 pieces smelt into a tin ingot. Okay, so like bronze should be like what, half and half? I honestly don't know everything. Bronze. I guess it would be probably tin bronze. Okay, 90% copper, 10% tin. Okay. So we actually have a good bit more tin than I thought. So that's good to know. We can do more than what I had initially thought. Get out of here. Where's the hole? Get in there. We'll feed the critters. Those that live below. Okay, give me this. This, grab this, do this. All right, pickaxe head, hammer time. What are we on? We should be on, I think, push. Now we're destroying things. God fucking damn it. Let's just do this. There we go. I'm thankful that picks are just super easy to make. What happens if I do this? It's not gonna do anything, right? Yeah. Okay. Can I just like, or is this no? Okay. All right, had to try. Kind of cute. Okay. All right. Do that. There we go. And now I think we just split to get rid of everything. There we go. And now, pickaxe acquired. Very easy. Do I want to do anything while this is? Nah, we'll just let it burn out. That's okay. Say, do I want to do anything with it while it's still cooking? But no, not now. Bronze is an eventuality. I need to get other things done before we start working on bronze. You just stay up there and do whatever it is you do, you evil thing. Been had some of our dinner here. How much more of our... How long does this have? Fresh for 10 hours. We have our smoked meat that's gonna last forever. We have berries. 0.3 servings. Like, can you not just... Oh, that's interesting. You can actually eat off of containers on the ground. I didn't know that. That's good to know. Shame I can't place it, like, on the table here, but... Oh, here. Let's get this guy on here. Do that. And... I wish that there was a hotkey that would let you light things with your offhand. That would make stuff so much easier to deal with. I think the veg on this is incorrect. Is it like... Can I not... Can I not make meat stew with bushcraft meat? Why? Why? Not suitable for meals. Son of a bitch. I just make cranberry stew then? No. Cranberry and grain? No. Cranberry and fat. Fat and grain, fat and cranberry. Son of a crap. Alright. Well. In that case, we'll just throw all the bush meat on there and it can sit and think about what it's done, I suppose. Cooking pot can... Oh my god. Cooking pot. Swear to god. This fucking game being fiddly like it does. Alright. Spelt can go in here. Cassorite nuggets are important. I need to not dump those somewhere where I'll forget about them. This is spoiling and we'll eventually be able to dump that. Oh no, those are poultices. Never mind. I say I thought they were seeds. They are not. Alrighty then. What I think I'm gonna do eventually is just rebuild all the walls in here as the conglomerate stone, cobblestone, and hope that that resolves our... No, see, now the vegetable power speed's 0.73. I don't know. Maybe it just needed time to figure out, oh, hey. It turns out I am a real boy and can serve as a seller for you. I have no idea. So how's this going? Yeah, the power speed's going down. I don't know. We have things... spoiling and all that fun jazz. Like I said, I still think I want to be replacing the walls. Music is so creepy. This would be like some good dungeon delving music for D&D. So good. There's a concept in tabletop role-playing games. It actually goes back a long, long ways, back to the origins of Dungeons and Dragons and dungeon crawling tabletop games. And it's the concept is called the Mythic Underworld. And basically what it is a game world explanation for why weird shit that works the way it does in dungeons works the way it does in dungeons. Like, for example, in most tabletop games, right? You're exploring a dungeon and the game master, referee, dungeon master, whatever, they know that the room that you're in has, you know, that you're entering is full of orcs, and then two rooms away there's another room with more orcs in it. But when you fight that first room full of orcs, generally speaking, you don't draw the attention of the other group of orcs. There may be some listen checks in some cases, but by and large, anyone who's ever been in like a large structure that is quiet or even like natural caverns and stuff will know that noise is so fucking loud. It travels like crazy. And if two groups of individuals are trying to murder the shit out of each other, that is going to be heard probably throughout an entire complex. And so trying to keep things reasonable towards the players and not, you know, any fight turns into them against an army of whatever the hell lives here. The concept of the mythic underworld was kind of born, and what it means is if you're in somebody's cellar, you're just in a cellar, right? It's not a big deal. But as you go deeper into the earth, the depths under the world basically inhibit your abilities to do things. Like, it's the dark is darker. Noise doesn't travel right. That's why, you know, if you killed that group of orcs in the first room, the group in the third room, they didn't even hear you. Because the mythic underworld just dulls the senses. And I don't know, I always thought that was a really cool concept. It's, you know, you're deep underground, and it feels like your torches that you've been using this whole time, they're just not shedding light like they used to. It's weird, the shadows are slowly closing in around you. And that's also used to explain how, you know, if you're in a dungeon, the monsters can always use the doors. They can use doors fine. They know how to open and close them. But party members, typically, if you try to open a door in a dungeon, most doors are, at least in old school dungeon crawling tabletop games, most doors are assumed to be stuck or locked. And so the PCs have to work to get through them. But the monsters know, like, the tricks of the trade, so to speak. It lets them navigate their space more readily than the players. And I don't know, I always thought it was just kind of cool. And it's one of those things that in a lot of newer editions, you know, you have your random encounter tables and they're all fights. But back in the day, it could be all kinds of things. It could be, you know, it could be a fight, or it could be a strong wind that just blows out of nowhere and blows out all your torches and stuff. And back in the day, that was a big deal because spellcasters didn't have unlimited cantrips for casting light and stuff. So, you know, if your torch was extinguished or your lantern was extinguished, that was a moment of tentative panic, depending on the current situation you were in. Always thought that was kind of interesting. It's a very different style of play from how modern D&D is. It's less heroic, it's more down to earth. And you can try to approximate that in newer D&D, but there's a lot of systems just aren't really made for that kind of gameplay. Okay, so now this is going to be open again because of this. Parish speed is still what it is. Okay, let's do this. Let's do this. I think it's clay and then just this. Look at that, I'm a genius. All right, and I got a text from my wife because heaven forbid I do anything during the day and not be interrupted. Jesus. Okay. I guess we'll just start replacing walls. I'm probably going to want to shore this up a little bit. My immediate goal is just to get walls put in. Once that's done, we'll go from there. There. Alright, so now we have this such as it is. But it does look like parish speeds are going down, which is good to hear. I would like to get some light down there, but I think that's going to require bronze and all that garbage. So first, let's get things going. Do some bulk work here. I don't think I've ever made quite this many blocks all in one go before. A whole 38 of them, because this game's stacking algorithm or whatever the hell they're using for splitting blocks up here is just fucky as all hell. Okay, good enough. I want to keep some of these just in case, and that gives us a fair amount of conglomerate cobblestone, which I'm quite pleased with here. Okay, so is this all done? No, of course it's not. Why would it be done? Why would we have finished our cooking? This game has a really good soundtrack. That's one thing, like, Minecraft as well has a really good soundtrack. It's just you rarely hear the music. Left click? Ah, no, there it goes. As I say, oh, we can't eat from this suddenly. Do this. Okay. Do I need... Where was... Is it right here? Yes. Okay, so that'll at least cover that. This, and I think this is gonna need to be replaced, I think. I don't like that there's a lip here like this. It gives access. I might expand my wood and peat storage out an extra block. I have to remember how to do this. Is it like this? Yes. Pain in the ass! But I suppose in this case it's a sensible one. Alright, alright. Come on, come on. Gimme, gimme, gimme. Let's do this. This, then this. And then, like, we're gonna have to move all of this. Can I, like, add peat? Remove peat. At least they let you do it quickly. You hold down shift. This could be far worse than it is. Okay, now, I think I'm gonna have to do this from inside, and it's gonna be like this. No. I'm not gonna make a wrench just to rotate these fucking things. There we go. Of course I can't do quite what I want, but that's okay. We'll make it work. There we go. All right. Not too bad. And we definitely have more peat storage now, which that makes me happy. This game's music is so chill. Oh yeah, that is a lot better. And then this. I'm gonna do it like this. It'll, god damn it. There we go. So yeah, it'll stack outward. Yeah, we're gonna be... we're gonna be needing some supplies here. No. Like this. There we go. Aesthetic! So do I bring in all the wood? No, I'm gonna leave this out here. I just like this. I like how this looks. Alright, so now... I need, like, corner stairs? Stairs. I think they just auto shape unless you have a wrench, don't they? That's a pain in the ass. Alright, in that case, I guess it's just gonna be blocks. Yes, that's exactly what I wanted to do, game. Punch dirt. Okay. There we go. So that's our storage area, and hopefully that will keep critters, for the most part, from climbing out. This is gonna... gonna bother me, but whatever. I think these things are going to be flowering shortly, aren't they? Less than a day, hell yeah. Okay, nothing there. Random anvil mold. Let's see how these guys are doing. Yeah, that's much better. Airspeed 0.83. Now we're going to need... I don't think I didn't see that go up there. Probably because I have the door open. I'm gonna need to do like an airlock on this thing so that I don't accidentally leave the door open. That's kind of obnoxious, but that's okay. All right. I do not have the materials for a door, I do not believe. Yeah, we need logs. All right. Before we do that though, let's go ahead and dump some of this stuff up. Oh man, I had a bunch of these and I didn't even realize it. Nice. I'm sure I will forget. And I do have some logs, actually. Alright, well shit. Door. Crude. Three sticks. Two of you. An axe. Three sticks. There we go. There, now ideally this will remind me that I need to not be a dum-dum, and we'll be able to figure that out. Okay, so. We're hungry. Let's go ahead and see if I can fill this thing off finally. It's just easier for me to pick these up than try to remember what jank-ass fucking combination of holding down control and shift I'm intended to use to manage them. Alright, good for 2 days, so I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna put it down in the basement. And you get good for 2.6 days. There you go. Sorry, this fell from upstairs. I totally forgot. Inventory full. Okay. Man, want to buy 7 Days to Die mod that lets you auto stack things to chests. Literally the best mod. Okay, that's flint, ethereal gears, poultices, steps. Random single conglomerate stone. Huge hides. I think that's from killing that bear. Horse tails. Okay, I'm gonna grab a labeled chest. Storage space. I need to be careful, because, like, now that I know that these guys fall, the chests fall? I've packed dirt. No. Okay, they do not. Good to know, because that's another container we're gonna have to fuss with when it falls is the other jar that's up there. I don't mind there being a jar in the basement. Like, we're gonna have all kinds of storage down there. It's just... kind of a pain. Alright, so how do I label this? Ulrich. Word of God. Okay, it looks like we need charcoal to be able to write text on this. Alright, that's a shame. Because I'm just gonna... I want to have one of these for plants, like seeds and stuff. And then the other is just going to be kind of a junk drop, basically. Inventory management, why you gotta be so terrible? Can I like... oh, I could just like... Genius! Okay, there we go. Fuck it. I do what I want. Up here, ethereal gear. Shit, what I'm probably not gonna use too much. Rusted gears. Conglomerate stone, your garbage. Get out. What is this? Low fertility soil? Also, it's ran. Seriously, game. Fucking throw it! Good lord. Packed dirt, I can make you anytime. I'd like to get some wood floors in here for the ground floor. I think we can do that now. I just need to make nails and shit, I think. I think. Famous last words. I tried thinking once. I don't recommend it. Okay, so this can just sit here for the time being. Eventually, I'm gonna have to go through all of this and we'll organize everything, but right now, just not happening. But yeah, some of this stuff's actually very important, like our feathers and shit. 46 days! Alright. 44 days! Okay, so the... why is some of the meat still going for months, and the other is just a couple days? I do not understand what broken logic is behind that. But okay. A shale. I think I've got... yes. This pack dirt I can probably just ditch. Labs, construction stuff. Lint, I'm just gonna hold on to. Lump of fat goes in here. Feathers go in here. This contains 1x rot. Nice. How do I dump it? Rah. Can I be eaten from shelves? Yeah, shelves are shelves. Okay, we gotta tab out here so that I can employ Google. Empty crock. How to empty a bowl of rotten food. Tossing it into water cleans it out. Well, that's for bowls. Alright, let's see if this actually works. It would be cool if it did. I think that's a nifty solution. I would have never thought to actually do it. Oh, that's pretty. We have little flowers now. Be gone! Well, I saw like... oh my god, it totally did. Huh. That's pretty nifty. Cool. Now we know. I wonder if you can do that with anything, any container full of whatever. Good to know, though. Definitely, definitely good to know. Oh, shit. I can sit there. This has like a third of a serving left. Let me eat this. Look at that. Now we have empty crocks. We have foods. Ah. It's all coming up, Millhouse. I have no idea what I want to do now. Do we work on tin? We have a liter of rot. Yo, dog. I heard you liked rot. It's actually useful for anything. Ingredient for compost. I suppose that makes sense, but I do not care. We need wood. Also, I need to relight my torch. One thing at a time. High action gameplay. We're, what, going on 20 episodes of this, and we're still just chopping trees like a peasant. We have, however, somehow managed to survive, which that's certainly something. All right. Mostly doing this for the sticks. Anything else? Hello, crab. You do you. Okay, and some pine cones. All right, so let's come back up here. What do I need? What do I need for floor? Oh, okay, how about wood? Wood rubble, wood bed, axe, pen, rabble, 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 wooden trunk. Boards. All right, yeah, we need boards for whatever I want to do here. Redwood slabs, okay. Now we can also do plaster. We do blocks? Yes, we can. Planks. All right, so we just need four redwood boards, which is redwood. That is, all right, use the quarter logs. Wait, what? All right, use a log and a saw. So I believe, I thought we had a saw floating around here somewhere. Pine. Bam. Oh, shit, okay. I wasn't expecting quite that many, but all right. Bam. Look at that. Let's make some extras. We're probably gonna actually need more, but look at that. We have real floors now. Fucking 20 episodes in and we've got wood floors, you guys. We're going places. I bet this is going to destroy our campfire when I dig this up. Yeah. No, okay, we're gonna have to go under to do some of this. I need to fucking light my torch. Such a fucking pain. It wouldn't be as obnoxious if I could light torches off of the wall sconce, but for whatever reason, you just can't. Good lord. Okay. All right, let's... I was gonna say, please don't drop my fucking tables. God damn it. It's such a pain in the ass. Why? What is the point of doing that, you sons of bitches? We are, of course, going to be a couple short. I'm going to leave this dirt here because that's where we're going to be putting our words. Combustibles, I suppose. Wood and peat. Oh god, I just realized it's placing these fucking things in different... why? Son of a bitch! Don't make that the default behavior. Let people do that... Like, is this the right way? There we go. Let people do that with a wrench once they get the wrench. Don't make placing floors fiddly. Good god. Ugh. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Gonna have to... I wonder if it's safe to have a campfire on wood. I would imagine possibly not. We'll figure out how we're gonna do that. So how many do I need here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 8. I need 12, 13, 14 of them. I'm just gonna make 16, whatever. We can have some leftovers. I don't give a shit. We'll find a use for them. Don't get me wrong, I appreciate that we can be persnickety about how we place our floors and stuff. And I'm sure using that, you can do some beautiful, beautiful things. I just... I have to move all this It's such a pain! Okay, let me dump some stuff here. I do not want to dump my cranberries, because otherwise they won't get eaten. The raft. Can I actually, like... place the raft here, I wonder. No. Alright. Figured I would try just to free up some inventory space. Our watering can. We have all this space up top and I'm just not using it. That needs to change. Come on. Come on. There we go. That's weird. There was some... when I was trying to jump up on this, there was some frame rate related buggery. No idea. Alright, random conglomerate stones. These I don't care about. We have a ton of conglomerate stone. Just making sure our lantern is still lit. Okay, so I guess what I'm gonna do is just take all of this. Just throw it up here. I mean, this is just kind of random crafty stuff. Although this is, the lump of fat is specifically for cooking. Well, actually, no, it's not, now that I think about it. It's for sealing containers, I suppose. So we have both rye and spelt grain. I love how these things are like, they're going bad faster. Good lord. Fucking game. Get in here. There. Now you can live forever. A year, 103 days. Yeah, that's what I like to see. Oh my lord. Okay, so now I can just dig this up and dig this up. Where to put it? I know it's in one of these. There it is. Give me this. Okay. Hello, oven. I'm gonna have to displace you momentarily. All right. Wood interior. oven can sit there. Planks. Love this game's music so much. All right. This guy can just sit down here and think about what he's done. Y'all need to get in my inventory one way or another. All right. Yeah, these can stay down here and just serve their purpose. I'll probably make another one. And then we'll have shelves. And ideally what I'll do is make some central shelves. I think you can do that. Maybe not. That's rather irksome, unless we can stack these things, perhaps. We might be able to. Because, yeah, I'd like to be able to just store a bunch of shelving in here. For food and so on. I could do, instead of those, I could just put slabs down or something. I don't know, it might look like shit. Okay, let's move. Stuff over here. These guys I'll take. No. I'll take. We finally graduated beyond the most basic level of literally everything. Antler. Fire starter. I guess I can just sit up here, forgotten with the other things that I'm probably never going to use again. Okay. Just fucking put it in the back. Put it in the back, you son of a bitch. There we go. Ah! All right. And that cooking pot, yeah, we're gonna need to figure out where I'm gonna have our cook fire. I'm not putting it here. I don't know. And I guess I could just throw it back here. Realistically, I should probably just keep it right fucking here. And the oven can just stay here. If I do that, I want one of these. Just in case. I don't know if it will catch fire, but I very, very much do not want to risk burning this place down. Because I fully expect this place would do that. And also, we already have our little chimney built here. I feel like I should maybe expand our thing out a little bit. Give us another level up here, but I do like how open it is in here, if I'm being honest. I don't know. I'm not gonna worry about it right now. I need to build a fire. Fire? Oh my god, I know how to do this. It's just fucking, I need sticks and grass. Where grass? There's grass. Inventory. Do this. Is it like, nope. Get out of here. Fire pit in construction. Control right click to refuel. It's not. You would think. Finding food, nap and knife, using a grass. Or pieces of fire. Oh, I specifically need firewood. Okay. I wouldn't have known that because long ago, we just swapped over to cooking on peat. Firewood is what? Just an axe and some trees. I keep fucking picking up these pelts. Do this. Okay. I've played video games. I do not want to put that much wood on this. There. Good enough. Did not mean to do that. Son of a bitch. There we go. Everything is difficult when you're me. It's incredibly tiring. There. Oh, that's gonna look so good once it's all stacked up. Ah, I'm so happy with that. So happy with it. And that can go there. Read chest. Basically useless, but we'll hold on to it anyways, because I can't get rid of things. Let's have some food. Dump that. What do we have here? Is any of this still good? 16 hours. Well, guess what? Berries for dinner. Just be crapping our guts out. It's okay. Awesome. See, what time is it? About 6 o'clock in the evening. 7 hours of sleep is not going to be enough, but we are also at 50 minutes. So I think I'm going to go ahead and call an episode here, and I will see y'all next time. I'm probably going to actually build us a real bed. Until then.